Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared that everything is halal except a few things that he forbade. قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَخْرَجَ لِعِبَادِهِ وَالطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ. Allah is challenging us. Who said that it is forbidden the good things Allah has given you in this life and the pure things? So by default, everything is permissible. And the realm of halal is very big. It is our understanding, which is very limited, that has restricted the options of halal. And it opens the doors, even in sports, encouraging, being involved in youth activities. That is the best way to manifest halal. It's not only about what's forbidden, what's not forbidden. It's about having fun and benefiting your body, benefiting your society, your community, your mind. The whole holistic approach of Islam, that's what halal is all about. It's about eating pure, being pure in your mind, in your body, in your talk. So halal is the concept of purity and trying your best. And you can never be perfect. The only perfect one is Allah. So you do your best. And it's about excellence. What we saw today, excellence in volunteerism, excellence in sport, competition, association, spirit of togetherness and working together. And that's the idea of halal, is bringing people. That's what you're doing here, is bringing, summoning all the halal business. You tell them, listen, we want you to work together, because the halal market is big, but we have underestimated it. And it could include, encompass all the businesses that work in the pure and the empowerment and enhancement of human life. That's how we understand halal. It's not some halal shop. This is the problem. We associate the halal shop, oh, this is the halal. No, halal is above and beyond that. Whatever is holistic, whatever is enhancing, empowering, relieving, whatever is pure is halal.
$4,920 hours of volunteerism. It's a huge number, and I'm glad that our administrators have logged these numbers last year for us to see what is the impact in the communities as well. But we don't only do soccer, we're encouraging and collaborating with other programs. We're working with another group to create an alternative program for skating. So we teach kids, especially the newcomers who are not aware of how the skates work. We encourage them to come out, remove that intimidation again, give them the alternatives to come out, join the community, learn how to skate and move on. We are collaborating with a group of ladies who are doing swimming for ladies only. That's not only for Muslims, Sheikh Salimi. There are more to this. There are people in the community here who appreciate the segregations in swimming pools. We're talking to Imam Salimi now about having a martial arts program coming in within Muslim Youth Soccer League to encourage our kids to do both. Some physical activities like this will help you on the game as well. We just created a program that started yesterday, volleyball for girls. Which when we heard from our girl that they need volleyball as a program, we created one starting yesterday. It's going to be every week till December. And if it succeeds, we will continue renting more courts and doing more. What we're trying to say here is, if there is a rule out there, basketball with no hijab, soccer with no turban, any of these rules that comes from bigger associations like the FIFA and the Basketball Association of North America, we want to remove those barriers. We want the kids to enjoy the sport. This is not about competition. We're not here to get the World Cup. We're here to communicate, to network with other human beings in societies and kids here in Mississauga get to know each other. My kids, when went to university, growing up in MSL, when they went to university, they said, "Dad, I met someone from MSL, someone from high school, and someone from the masjid." MSL becomes a networking circle that we're very proud to see happening between our kids. And then we're encouraging kids to coach when they grow up, to ref when they grow up. So we're putting that leadership development into it as much as we can. We're working with very small resources, as you know, but we have a lot of support from the community, alhamdulillah. Every center, mashallah, have showed their support. Khadija Center have showed us our support. ISNA have showed us our support. Al-Huda have showed us our support. There's a lot of support coming from the community, alhamdulillah, and we're very, very appreciative.